Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. This video describes the recently approved drug, LOTILANER, sold under the brand name Xdemvy. This video emphasizes the MedChem properties of the drug rather than the clinical pharmacology. If you happen to be a scientist who worked on this project and are at liberty to speak about this research or your general work at Tarsus Pharmaceuticals, I would be very interested in interviewing you for a separate video. The channel email address is in the video description. The approval of LOTILANER's NDA was granted on the 25th of July in 2023. The active ingredient is LOTILANER, which is the U.S. adopted name. The branded name of the drug is Xdemvy. LOTILANER is administered as an ophthalmic solution with a concentration of just 0.25%. The dose is just one drop per eye, twice per day. The dosing regimen extends for 6 weeks. LOTILANER's indication is Demodex blepharitis, which we'll discuss more in a moment. Tarsus Pharmaceuticals sponsored the NDA. All this information can be found through the prescribing information of LOTILANER through the link at the bottom of the screen. LOTILANER is approved to treat Demodex blepharitis. Blepharitis is an inflammation of the eyelid, and Demodex is a genus of mites that can inhabit hair follicles. So, LOTILANER kills the mites that cause the infection and eyelid inflammation. LOTILANER acts as an antiparasitic. Structurally, LOTILANER is a member of the isoxazoline drug class. So, on the left, I have an isoxazole. That is a five-membered ring with an oxygen and nitrogen in a 1-3 position relative to each other. The ring is aromatic. In contrast is the isoxazole ring. This is also a five-membered ring with an oxygen and nitrogen, but they have a 1-2 relative position. Isoxazole is also aromatic. Isoxazole is an isomer of the oxazole ring. An isoxazoline is a five-membered ring with a nitrogen and oxygen with a 1-2 relationship, and the ring is not aromatic but still retains a pi bond. There are multiple isomers of isoxazolines. This example is specifically a 2-isoxazoline. These naming conventions fall into an obscure corner of organic chemistry called Hantzsch-Widman nomenclature, which is encountered throughout medicinal chemistry in the naming of various compounds. If we look at the structure of LOTILANER, we can clearly see the isoxazoline ring system. Many isoxazolines developed as drugs have antiparasitic activity, which is to say that LOTILANER is not the only antiparasitic isoxazoline. Here are four different isoxazolines with antiparasitic activity. They all have clear structural similarities, such as they all contain an isoxazoline with a trifluoromethyl group and some variation of a halogenated aromatic ring. All the compounds on the screen are veterinary drugs for use in animals, mostly cats and dogs, for the treatment of flea and tick infestation. So the isoxazolines are active against not only mites, but also fleas and ticks. These compounds antagonize an ion channel, a GABA receptor, that is found in fleas, ticks, and mites. The specific ion channel is not found in mammals, so the isoxazolines show low toxicity in animals, like cats and dogs. Note that LOTILANER, the star of this video, is in the lower right. So, LOTILANER was originally developed as a veterinary drug and now has found use in humans for mite infestations of the eyelid. I am sure there is more to this story. LOTILANER is an actively marketed veterinary drug under the trade name of Credelio, a trademark held by Elanco. The emergence of LOTILANER under the Xdemvy trade name at this time may be possible through either expiration of another company's intellectual property, such as a composition of matter patent, or the novelty of use against mites in humans as opposed to a veterinary use. If anyone has insight into the circumstances around the IP of this compound, please do share it in the comments section. Let's look at some physicochemical properties of lotilaner. When I look at small molecule drugs, and lotilaner is a small molecule drug, I tend to think of the drug relative to oral drugs. With that perspective, we see that lotilaner has a fairly high molecular weight of nearly 600 grams per mole. The log P is also high, at over 6. Of course, these value judgments are based on ideas like Lipinski's rules, which are intended for orally administered drugs, and lotilaner is not orally administered. It is a topical drug administered as ophthalmic drops. So while the isoxazoline drugs are in fact administered orally for veterinary purposes, in humans, lotilaner is not an oral drug. The reported PK properties in humans are very limited. Lotilaner is absorbed into the plasma from its site of administration in the eye, at least to a small degree. The half-life of lotilaner in humans is exceedingly long, at 11 days. The clearance, volume of distribution, and bioavailability, that's oral bioavailability, are unknown. Plasma protein binding is high. None of the drug is observed unchanged in the urine. So, since the drug was originally developed to be administered topically, there isn't much to discuss in terms of the traditional pharmacokinetic parameters. If we can't discuss PK, what can we discuss? Well, how about safety? The most common adverse reaction was stinging in the eyes during administration. Although the drug is observed in the plasma, lotilaner does have low systemic exposure, which does contribute to a lower safety risk in the drug. Keep in mind that each dose is just 2 drops, one in each eye, of a solution that is only 0.25% lotilaner. Only a fraction of that administered drug reaches the plasma, so systemic exposure is indeed very low. The drug shows no mutagenicity, and cytochrome-mediated metabolism is negligible in humans, which contributes to the long 11-day half-life of the drug in the plasma. Those are some highlights for lotilaner, marketed as Xdemvy. Lotilaner is approved for the treatment of Demodex blepharitis. Lotilaner is an uncommon example of a drug that was first approved for veterinary use and now has been approved for human use. Thank you for watching to the end of this drug approval summary for lotilaner. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.